It's Teresa from Dodge Nature Center, and I have a great book to read to you today. We've been learning all about air around us. The title of this book is Air is All Around You. It's written by Franklyn M. Branley and illustrated by John O'Brien. So read along with me as we learn all about the air that's around us. Air is all around you. There is air down in a deep valley. There is air around a high mountain. Wherever you go, there is air. Cars and houses are filled with it. So are barns, sheds, dog houses, and bird houses. Cups are full of it. So are bowls, pots, and glasses that we drink out of. That's hard to believe, because you can't see the air or smell it. You can't feel it either, except when it's moving or when you spin around. You can't see the air in a glass, but you can prove it is there. Try this experiment. Stuff a paper napkin into the bottom of a glass. Turn the glass upside down. If the napkin falls out, stuff it in tighter. Run a lot of water into the sink, or put water in a big bowl. Color the water with a little food coloring, not much, just enough to color it a little bit. Keep the glass upside down. Make sure it is straight up and down. Do not tip it. Push it all the way under the water, or as far under as you can. Lift the glass out of the water, turn it right side up, and take out the paper napkin. It is dry. The water did not touch it. The paper was under the water, but it did not get wet. Let's see why. Once again, put the napkin in the glass. Turn the glass upside down and push it under the water. Look at the glass through the water. The water does not go into it. It can't go in because there is air in the glass. But you can make the water go in. Tip the glass a little bit. A bubble of air goes out and up. When the air goes out, there is empty space in the glass. Water goes in. You can see it. The coloring you added to the water helps you see it. Bubbles go out and water goes in. Keep tipping the glass until all the air goes out. Now it is full of water and the napkin is soaking wet. When the glass was full of air, there was no room for water. When the air went out, the water went in. Air is all around you, and it is all around the earth. It covers the earth like peel covers an orange. The air weighs a lot, 5 quadrillion tons. That's 5,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000, in the room where you are weighs more than you think. In an average room, the air weighs 75 pounds or so. If the room is big, the air in it weighs more. If it is small, the air weighs less. We don't feel it because the air is spread all around us. Airplanes and balloons fly in the air, but spaceships don't. Rockets push them higher than the air. Spaceships fly above the air that is all around the Earth. Spaceships must take air with them. They have enough to keep the astronauts alive. When they go out of the ship, astronauts carry tanks of air on their backs. They need air to stay alive. And so do you and I. Lucky for us, air is everywhere. Wherever we go on Earth, there is air. Air is even in water. That's lucky for fish. The air is dissolved in the water. You can't see the air, but you can prove that it is there. Fill a glass with water. Set the glass aside and leave it for an hour. After an hour, you will see tiny bubbles on the inside of the glass. They are tiny bubbles of air. The air came out of the water. Fish use the air that is dissolved in water. They have gills that help them do this. Air keeps them alive. We can't breathe air that is dissolved in water. So when we stay underwater a long time, we have to take air with us. Divers take air in tanks strapped to their backs. Air keeps us alive. Wherever we go on Earth, north, south, east, or west, high on a mountain or deep in a valley, there is air. Air is all around us. The end. Thanks for reading along and joining us for another Dodge Distance Learning lesson. Bye.